in the hell? They aren't supposed to be here. Auto train with BNSF power pulling in. Just hanging out here down by the yard in the shade. Key. It's about to be super hot today and this entire week. It's like not even 10 a.m. and I worked up a full raging sweat just going 150 yards from my backpack and everything. So I hid that shit out in the bushes and now I'm just kind of like hanging out around town, walking around. I got some friends who are catching out from Ogden right now and they'll probably be here today. Maybe not till like the late evening or maybe even the middle of the night, but it's really not a far ride from there. So yeah, I'll probably head down to the river and get clean and go swimming for a while. Been napping here in the shade for the past couple hours. We got these thunderstorms kind of just appeared out of nowhere. There was one building to the south earlier and it pushed north and dropped just a few drops of rain on me, barely. It was way over there though. Now we got a big one over here too. I might get wet today. Raining, ducked into the subway to get a veggie delight and some cover from the rain. My hands and my arms, probably my face, are pretty dirty right now. And the lady working the counter knew it was up and she asked me if I'm traveling and all the whole nine yards. I told her the deal and she just gave me my sandwich for free because it wouldn't mess up their inventory. You really can't beat that. They even just call it Club 86. That's where you're supposed to be in Green River. My backpack's getting rained on right now. Oh well. Well, Green River is just about my favorite train town on the west, really. As far as a place to lay over and just hang out, especially during the summertime, you really can't beat it. Great weather, great river access, tons of trains, small quiet town, and one of my favorite things is the Arctic Circle. Most of the country or most people won't know about this, but it's just this bumfuck little fast food chain. It's predominantly in Utah, a little bit of bleed over into Wyoming. I think they had or have one somewhere in Oregon. I think that's more of a had. But anyway, yeah, it's just fast food, but for the price, you get a great cheap little burger. And so I'm gonna go treat myself to one of them right now. Match my backpack. I'm so proud of this. That's right. Anyway, that'll probably be it for the evening. I'm definitely tired after the day on the train yesterday and not really sleeping a whole lot the night before. And I'm just going to go back to camp. Looks like we'll get some more thunderstorms coming in at some point here. And yeah, hopefully it don't rain. It was a long, wet night. It really never rained a lot, but it rained more consistently throughout the night than I would have hoped. Multiple 3-hour long thunderstorms where it drizzled just enough that you couldn't be out. And yeah, over the course of the night, it soaked through all my tarps and my bivy and everything, and my legs, I'm all wet right now, but thankfully it is summertime, even though these clouds are still hanging on today, but it should get warm enough here to dry everything out. I think my friends are probably in town somewhere right now, sleeping off their train ride, and yeah, just gonna dry some shit out, pack up, and head on in probably, track them down whenever they wake up.
July in Green River. Got some fellow train riders over there across the river I've been hanging out with. Two of them. I expected one of them. We didn't expect. They knew. One of the other folks I know, and so we're all hanging out. I saw like 3 other kids in town earlier this morning. They waved. But there have been quite a few people in town lately.
Yeah, I cook my food in my dog food bowl. She cleans the dishes.
I said someone's looking at. I thought someone said.
Good. Where's mine? She
got it.
I'm not worried. She won't go anywhere. She's fine.
Goddamn, we're free! We can fucking ride trains and like deal with pretty, I'm gonna say, minimal cop harassment.
Yeah, right. There are countries where people like are executed for having a small amount of any drug.
Yeah.
And like I can both ride trains for hundreds of thousands of miles on drugs and get away with only a misdemeanor. Right?
The government probably brought them into the neighborhood that I bought.
Straight up, yes. Yeah. Right, thank you, yeah. God bless them stars and stripes, brother.
How does that go? Fuck you. But no, you can suck my dick. How does that go? If you're scared of thunder.
Thank you. It'll resupply on the canned goods before we go grab an eastbound train. I think I'm just gonna take it to Cheyenne. Chilling out here. Everybody's getting resupplied. I got myself another delicious veggie delight. This is the go-to. It's hard to get vegetables out here. And these are cheap, you know? Anyway, plan from here. We're all getting on the eastbound. The other two are gonna go all the way to Clinton, and I'm gonna get off in Cheyenne.
You wait for the FD Energy Unit.
1969? Heritage Unit 42069? Where?
Fucking those 2 yard dogs.
Took literally all day for an intermodal to show up, so we have elected to hang out for the night, enjoy our time, and grab something out in the AM, and then I can just hop off and they'll keep going, as that will be the train they want to take them all the way on to Clinton. My new friend David just ambushed this UP worker from around the corner. Oh, hi, Hank. And there goes David and Katie. Katie, go! They're heading to Pocatello.
You sure we're just back
that way? I recommended that as well. Well, David sent me a text. He is somewhere out there, safely aboard this Pocatello train. And I was really hoping to see him off, but it's been half an hour or more now, and the train hasn't moved or shown any sign of moving, so it's probably waiting on an inbound. And we're gonna get on out of here. Fantastic to meet you, though, David. And if I have things going my way, I'll be seeing him again next month in Reno. I'm gonna try to get him hooked up on this gig I'm working and make him some money. He's talking about buying himself a car. Thank you.
that's where right now.
Decided out in the middle of nowhere because we had a handbrake set somewhere like probably two-thirds of the way down the train, and they actually had a work vehicle that we're about to move finally come out here. We slowed down, dropped off one of the crew members, slow rolled the train. He found the brake that was set. The mechanic checked the bearing, and dispatch has given us a track warrant with a 30 mile per hour restriction up to the next control point or the next detector, and then we're going to see if we're good to go from there. cooking again.
Took probably an hour to get that mechanical problem sorted out, but we're back highballing. Coming up on Rawlins will be the next significant town or train stop. That's probably at least an hour out, you know, hour and a half. Notably, right there before Rawlins is the Continental Divide.
Currently pressing down on top of the Continental Divide. It's pretty wild landscape, and you can't tell it's flat through here, but we're at like 8,000 feet right now.
The Laramie Mountains, probably the most scenic part of this entire trip. Get fucked, Hank. It's been very slow. We refueled in Rawlins, and then there was probably like a 3-mile convoy of full-blown track replacement going on. And yeah, it's coming up on like 5 p.m. now, probably, or what, 4 maybe? I don't know. We've been on this train for quite a while, and we have quite a while left. Yeah. So, we're hoping to get there in time to buy a pizza. Over.